So till now, so far almost we have covered all the topics in the first unit. The theory part, required theory part already are given, and wherever important problems are there, they also the problems also have discussed. Whatever problems still have missed in the during the explanation of concepts, I will cover here. So problems already I have written here. Check whether U of T is the standard representation for unit step signal, right? So check whether U of T, unit step signal, is an energy signal or power signal. So the same problem we can also expect, like find out energy value as well as power value for the given signal U of T. Okay, because even to conclude whether the given signal is an energy signal or power signal, we have to calculate both energy values as well as power values. Because the definition of energy signal or power signal depends on energy value as well as power value. Okay. So here this problem includes calculation of energy value, calculation of power value, and checking whether the given signal is energy signal or power signal. Okay. First, what is the formula for energy of a signal X of T? X of T signal energy formula is minus infinite to infinite mod of X of T whole square dt, right? But what is the signal given to us? Minus infinite to infinite U of T magnitude whole square dt. But what about U of T signal? Do you all remember the signal? It's like this, right? It is defined only from 0 to infinite. For remaining negative side, there will be no amplitude. It is 0 on negative side. So the signal is defined only from 0 to infinite, because from minus infinite to 0 signal is not defined. 0 amplitude is there. So from 0 to infinite, what is the magnitude of U of T? 1 is there. So 1 whole square dt. Okay. Now 0 to infinite 1 into dt. What about its integration? 0 to infinite t. Upper limit minus lower limit infinite. So energy value we got it as infinite for the given signal. Next, let us go for power calculation. What is the formula for power? Limit t tends to infinite 1 by 2t minus t to t mod of x of t whole square dt. Isn't it? Now here in our problem, limit t tends to infinite 1 by 2t, but our signal is defined only from 0 to t. T can be anywhere in the range of 0 to infinite. Okay. So here limits are only from minus t to t. Minus t to 0 I am not considering. Negative side there is no signal amplitude. U of t is not at all defined. So we have to take only positive limits. Only positive side U of t is defined. Isn't it? So 0 to t our signal is U of t whole square. So what is the magnitude of U of t? I have to substitute 1 into dt. 1 square is anyhow 1 again. Now limit t tends to infinite 1 by 2t 0 to t 1 into dt, right? So what is the integration of 1? T. So here I am changing it as t. Okay. Now upper limit minus lower limit. Limit t tends to infinite 1 by 2t. Upper limit, lower limit subtraction. Tt will get cancelled. Limit t tends to infinite simply 1 by 2. T is not there. So power value is 1 by 2 watts. So energy value is infinite, power value is finite. So we call this as a power signal. The given U of T signal is a power signal. Why? Because power equal to finite, here we got it as 0.5 watts, energy is infinite. If it is an energy signal, power is going to be 0, energy is going to be finite value. Like this, using these formulas, we need to check whether the given signal is energy signal or power signal. This is the processor to calculate energy value as well as power values. Okay. Now, next problem is x of t equal to e power j 2t. Find its even and odd components. Okay. Do you all remember the formula for... Actually, in general, any signal is a combination of its even component plus odd component. Already we have calculated the formula for even component. How we have calculated? X of minus t by derivation already we have seen. Now for this even part, x e of t is, what is x of t given? E power j 2t plus x of minus t means wherever t is there, replace with minus t, minus 2t by 2. Now e power j theta means cos theta plus j sin theta. So this is cos 2t plus j sin 2t minus of cos 2t minus j sin 2t. Okay, by 2. Now here it is cos 2t plus j sin 2t minus cos 2t plus j sin 2t by 2. These two will get cancelled. What is the expression we got? 2j sin 2t by 2. So finally j sin 2 theta is a even component. Like that, next we have to calculate odd component also. What is the formula for odd component? X of t minus x of minus t by 2. Means here e power j 2t minus e power minus j 2t. Means here minus all I have taken. So actually here it is a plus. Please change this. Plus. Plus cos 2t. Plus into minus. Minus j sin 2t. So finally if I change this, what will get cancelled here? Cos 2t. Here even component formula is x of t plus x of minus t by 2. E power j2t plus e power minus j2t by 2. E power j2t means cos 2t plus j sin 2t plus minus j2t means cos 2t minus j sin 2t. Now just a simplification. Plus cos 2t minus j sin 2t. Now what will get cancelled? This will get cancelled. Now 2 cos 2t by 2. Finally what I get even component as? Cos 2t. So, previously here I have taken minus. Here plus is there for even component. Plus we need to substitute. Now to find the odd component x of t minus x of minus 2t. Here minus you take. Multiply both these two terms with minus. Solve. There we are going to get j sin 2t as odd component. Like what we did. Okay. So we are discussing problems. Okay. So energy, power calculation, even odd components already we have seen. Next one is periodicity. Find the periodicity of three problems I have taken. Let us go for this first one. X of t is given as sine 12 pi t. So in the first a bit, x of t equal to sine of 12 pi t. Okay. In general, whenever sine or cos is given, we have to compare it with sine omega t. In place of omega, what is there here? 12 pi. But what is mean by omega? 2 pi by t. 12 pi. Now capital T is 2 pi by 12 pi. 1 by 6 seconds. Like this we need to calculate. Now for the second problem, B bit x of t is given as e power j 4 pi t. So in general our standard exponential signal is e power j omega t. In our problem in place of omega 4 pi is there. But what is omega? 2 pi f or 2 pi by t equal to 4 pi. Now what is t? 2 pi by 4 pi. It is 1 by 2 seconds. Like that. Now in the third one. In the third one x of t is a product of sin c beta pi t into u of t. See here, sin is always a periodic signal with periodicity depending on factor here. But u of t is a like this signal. When I multiply these two, it is a periodic signal. If I multiply these two, I am going to get like this, isn't it? This is a periodic signal, whereas u of t is a non-periodic signal. Now, if I multiply these two, finally I am going to get a non-periodic signal. Because sine is always a periodic. U of t is a non-periodic signal, isn't it? It is not having any periodicity. It is a straight up, unit one amplitude signal. So, whatever path is there like this, the signal is going to come. Sine 12, sine pi t signal. So, the product of periodic and non-periodic is always a non-periodic signal. Okay, this is about the problems on periodicity. Please go through the Anand Kumar textbook. Different models have been given. Try to solve all those problems. Next, Properties of unit impulse. Unit impulse function already we have seen. How do we represent unit impulse? Delta of t is the representation. Few properties are there. Okay, few properties. So these are the periodicity problems. Non-periodic signal, u of t periodic. Finally, x of t is going to be non-periodic signal. Like that, okay. Now coming to properties, even function delta of t, this is my function delta of t, right? It exists only at t equal to 0 with amplitude as 1, minus infinite to infinite range. Over in the entire region it is 0, but it is defined exactly at t equal to 0, okay, amplitude is 1. So it is an even function, delta of minus t, even if I substitute minus t also I am going to get, because delta of t amplitude equal to 1 at t equal to 0. If I replace t with minus t, constant, minus t equal to 0, nothing but t equal to 0 only. So it is delta of t equal to delta of minus t. It is an even function. Next, for example, please refer this first. I am explaining this one. Delta of t minus a means, one positive, one negative sign means right shifting. So, 0 is going to start from constant A. Amplitude 1. Means whatever amplitude is there at 0, it is going to be shifted to A. So, this signal is right shifted by A times. So, delta of T minus A multiplied with X of T. For example, X of T you can take any random signal like this. Okay. Now, I am going to multiply these two. Multiplication of this one with this one, isn't it? Finally, resultant signal I am going to draw here. So, over the range minus infinite to infinite, delta of t minus a is defined exactly at t equal to a only. For remaining all the instant, it is giving 0 amplitude. Whereas here, minus infinite to infinite, the signal amplitudes are there. But 0 multiplied with all these amplitudes, I am going to get zeros only, all zeros, because wherever zeros are there in the first signal, all zeros except at t equal to a. At t equal to a, whatever amplitude is there here, at t equal to a, x of a, that particular amplitude I am going to get. Okay, clear? So here x of t into delta of t minus a is nothing but x of a only, means all zeros I am multiplying with these amplitudes, zeros. Exactly at t equal to a, 1 into, here amplitude is x of a. Finally, I am going to get x of a only, isn't it? So, here x of a. Now, integration. When I am integrating this product also, all the ranges, integration is nothing but addition. 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus x of a plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus. So, the integration exists only at a single value at t equal to a. So, even integration is also same as x of a. These two properties are same. Integration is nothing but addition of values. This function is defined only at single value t equal to a. So, even though if I add all the values from minus infinite to infinite, single value x of a I am going to get. For remaining all the values, amplitude is 0. Now, x of t into delta of t. This is x of t. This is my delta of t. At t equal to 0, amplitude is 1. At t equal to 0, here amplitude is x of 0. Now, if I multiply these two, what I am going to get? Here all are zeros. Here all our amplitudes are there. These amplitudes were multiplied with these zeros, 0 amplitudes only. But exactly at t equal to 0, there is amplitude 1. From 0, again here, zeros. These amplitudes are multiplied with these amplitudes, zeros. So, exactly at t equal to 0, there is an amplitude x of 0, which is multiplied with the corresponding amplitude 1. 1 into x of 0, x of 0, like that. And the last property is x of t convolution delta of t. So, any function convolved with impulse function going to give the same function. This property again we are going to verify in third unit. Okay. These are the important properties of impulse function. We can also use these properties in solving the integrations also. Let us see one example. One simple example let us see. For example, solve the integration. solve the integration 0 to delta of t. So let us solve the integration this one. Now see here, minus infinite to infinite, which is in the form minus infinite to infinite t minus 2 into delta of t. So here x of t into delta of t. So that means t minus 2 into delta of t. What is its value? It is defined as x of 0. What is x of t here? T minus 2. X of 0 means t equal to 0, we have to substitute minus 2. So here 0 to 2 minus 2 into dt, because this product value is minus 2. Now minus 2 into integration of dt is t only, upper limit 2 minus 0, minus 4. Like this we need to solve the integrations also, using the, you can solve the integrations also using these properties. Okay. Okay, this is about solving the integrations.